Alex Carruthers. I'm biting the bullet for substance abuse and mental health. I was maybe like 17, 16, typical dude, drinking with friends. I always idolized rock stars. Jim Morrison was somebody I admired since I was a young kid. I used to sit in front of the TV and watch videotapes of The Doors play live at the Hollywood Bowl. And I used to have my microphone. I used to fall down onto the ground alongside Jim Morrison in the video. And those are some of my earliest memories of that feeling of desire. I think struggle is just a natural part of our human existence. We all struggle with things. We carry things with us like baggage. And I had all these things that I accumulated over many years. I carried all of the shit and junk from my childhood. I carried it over into my teen years. I carried the pain and struggles of my parents and my grandparents. I carried the pain and struggle of everybody around me. I piled that on and I kept it inside. And when I think about going back to when I was a kid, when I was that kid in front of that microphone, I think it makes me realize that I eventually just couldn't take it anymore. That music was an escape for me, but eventually it wasn't enough. And I think I turned to substances as a way of running for myself. I don't think I'm alone in it. I've learned that, you know, I'm definitely not the only one in it. It affects a lot of people. I think it affects so many people that a lot of people don't even know that, you know, it affects them that much. I've started to learn that my strength isn't in the absence of fear. But it's in learning how to conquer that fear. That's where I truly find my strength. The struggle is constant. It doesn't just go away. It's not like, you know, you just wake up one day and you just realize that, you know, everything is just perfect and it's gonna be all right and you can do anything and this is a moment of like beautiful awakening. It's not quite like that. You know, it's very, very slow movements towards a goal of life, of finding purpose in your life. I constantly struggle with addiction. My mental health is constantly teetering. But you know, I think I've learned to be all right with it and just remind myself that I'm strong enough to push through it. What I don't idolize about rock stars anymore is that the ones that I all loved are all dead. Because I think they were lost and they were struggling. And they never found that purpose that they so desired. They never let go of all that fear and all that anxiety. And they built it up over and over, just like me. But I don't think anybody helped them. I don't think they ever got to really realize the importance of their life. 27 Club, I always thought I was gonna die at 27. And I was like, fuck it. Because I thought that was something to idolize. I thought that was something I wanted. That I would somehow leave this legacy behind. Meanwhile, all I was doing is shoving my nose and filling my stomach up with booze. My biggest desire in life is to be loved and to give love, that I desire to give love, and that's the only way that I will truly find happiness in my life is through love. I still want to be a rock star, just not like I did when I was a young vet. I mean, I think it started off with liquor, but it was coke was like cocaine was like a huge thing, just because it became so commonplace. It was something that people just did all the fucking time, and they still do. And it's just that the taboo is it's somehow washed away around it for me. You know, I used to think when I was, you know, a teen, like, that's like, I will never do that. That's fucking, you know, that's way over there. What the fuck is that? That's heroin. You know, and then it just sort of, one day it was just sort of around.
Are you sober now?
I'm not 100% sober, no. It's definitely something that I have learned to control. But that's not to say that it's not a constant fear, you know, because there's that balance, right? There's that balance of if you put yourself into a situation, a few too many drinks inside of you, you put yourself around the wrong people and the wrong triggers, that's when it becomes really hard. That's when you really test yourself. And I'm not gonna sit here and say I'm over all of my addictions and that I'm somehow just better now. I think it's gonna be a constant struggle for maybe ever. I hope not forever, but maybe. But I've learned to acknowledge it and to keep fighting. You know, that's what I didn't have before. I think the problem with taking drugs or a substance to deal with depression is that it can help relieve you of that momentary stress. It can allow your mind to focus on whatever the fuck makes you happy in that 1 second. But it's sort of like when you have a cold and you have a fever, and then you give yourself a drug to help you with that pain of that moment, and then you get drunk, let's say. And for a period of time, you cannot feel sick. You'll forget about your body literally telling you, you know, to fuck off. But when all that stuff wears off, your sickness is still there. And I think that is sort of like what happens when you use substances to avoid mental health issues. You feel momentarily satisfied, but it's not gone. You haven't dealt with it. I think in order to get over depression, you really have to do the things that make your mind and body happy, which aren't turning to substances. You know, for me, boxing, music, those are some of the things that make me happy. They make my mind strong, they make my body strong. To have a strong mind, to have a strong body, these are the things that are gonna help you overcome depression. Not staying up till, you know, 10 in the morning. I think it's just, it's a good time to be reminded that, you know, you're not alone. That there's a lot of people that feel like you. There's a lot of people that feel like me. And that you are not alone. You know, reaching out and asking for help, explaining your story, the act of confession is a beautiful release. It can be the first step to getting to a better place, to getting to higher ground. We all need help sometimes.